This is Dr. Lam of drlam.com and the Adrenal Fatigue Center. Today we're going to talk about the functional differences between T4 and T3 thyroid hormone. A lot of people are being put on thyroid hormone nowadays when they complain to their doctor of having fatigue and no other reasons could be found. The purpose of T4 in the body is to convert into T3, although T4 does have its own function. T4 is actually not the body's main hormone, although it's the most prominent and most high in terms of volume. The workhorse of the body's thyroid hormone is actually T3, which is the biochemical daughter of T4. They both have their own individual purposes, although T4 in general is weaker, much weaker than T3. The body makes it in different proportion in order to have the proper use at the right time and the right place. So there is functional differences, although they both increase metabolism, and both thyroid hormones have that function as the primary reasons for their existence. Now, when you are given T4, another trade name is Synthroid, the body converts the T4 automatically into T3, which is also called cytomel if you're taking it in the form of a medication. Some drugs, such as Armour Thyroid or Naturethroid, comes in a pre-mixed percentage that has the T4 and T3 in this similar proportion as what is found in the body. So this attempts to mimic the body's composition in terms of the circulating T4 and T3. Most people are started on T4 to begin with, or Synthroid is commonly used in the US. And if things don't work as well, then the doctor can add or switch to T3. And there's a good reason to do that. And it's because, remember, we said that T4 is really a precursor to T3 and is not as strong. Therefore, you allow the body's feedback loops to be intact. If T4 is not working well, if the body needs more strong thyroid hormones, such as T3, then it can be added. In some times, the body can have resistance problems and develop many, many issues that stop the conversion from T4 to T3. And this is another situation where T3 may be used. A thyroid medication is a very complex subject. In the case of adrenal fatigue, where it can lead to hypothyroid type symptoms when the thyroid laboratory could be normal, this can further convolute the picture and can be quite confusing. Understanding the role T4 and T3 mix in the body is very important. There's so many signs and symptoms of thyroid problems, including dry skin, losing eyebrows, outer third, fatigue, reduced exercise capacity, weight gain. These are very common presenting complaints to any physician's office. And it is very easy, and it's a commonly accepted practice for the physicians to give a T4 and T3. Whether or not you should take it depends on the clinical situation. So you need to really discuss this matter closely with your doctor. If your fatigue is, for example, due to other reasons other than a primary thyroid problem, such as if you have anemia or you have under severe stress or you have adrenal weakness, then you don't want to mask these problems. You want to basically deal with these issues at the root cause, and then you can avoid taking thyroid medication. If you take thyroid medication for not the right reasons, you can mask the underlying problem, and that could have long-term and negative effects. So understanding the thyroid functions, the T4, T3 is important. And you should really talk to your doctor if you are already on, especially if your dosage had to be increased over time, or if you're not getting the benefit from the thyroid, which all of which can mean that there's some other issues that are going on that may need to be further investigated. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I've written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.